Alright, hi everybody, this is A7X Fan Ben, and this is going to be the Zeus tutorial building video. So I got the Zeus from another Pirates community member not too long ago. You may have seen my unboxing video of it. So in this video, I'm going to try to show you how to build a 10 master. This is something I haven't done in a while, and they're the biggest ships in the game, so it'll definitely take a while. I actually spent 40 minutes building my first 10 master, which was the Delusion, because I was really afraid to break it and I wanted to assemble it right. So in the Zeus package, PP757, they do have the instructions on the back, but they're not super helpful sometimes. It makes sense, but it's good to have a video too, because sometimes there's only four steps in the directions, whereas there's, you know, four parts or more per step, sort of. So this will take a while, and I haven't built a 10 master in a little while, maybe a few years. Well, yeah, I think so, since the Celtic Fury was my last unpunched one. So it'll be interesting to see how I do. Hopefully I'll get all the steps right, because it's supposed to be a tutorial. So hopefully you'll learn something from this. The Zeus, one of the best ships in the game. So here we go. I guess it'll lose value in a few seconds when I punched out, but this is certainly my play copy, hopefully forever. Hopefully I won't break it at any point or anything like that, or need another one. So here comes the Zeus. So the first thing I'm going to do is just punch out all the pieces, and I'm going to put all the masts in one area. And one thing I have set up, I've got my blue background here because I like that. This is an extra Typhoon card that I don't have the deck plate for. I got a long time ago. You can see the mizzen mast is all white because I usually use that or some of the other pieces to widen slots. You can use a ballpoint pen or an X-Acto knife, things like that, to widen slots if they're too tight. So, and I think Ocean's Edge and Junks in particular, those are two of the things that people have trouble building, or at least I've had trouble in the past. So this might be a tough one to get the pieces in. So we'll see what happens. But, and you'll immediately notice if you get a 10 master how gigantic it is. So the hull here is probably a good 5 inches or so. One thing I like to do, I haven't talked about this yet, but I might as well talk about it now. You see how these little white things on the sides there? I don't like those because sometimes when you put the deck up there, sometimes they prevent the deck from being flush against the hull pieces. So I actually like to scratch those off. In this case, that might add some extra time to the build, but it's the Zeus, so you might as well do it right the first time. So I'm just going to do that. I don't know if my camera's even going to have enough battery for this entire video, the first shoot, but we'll see. So I'm going to scratch those little pieces off. Might seem kind of brutal, but at the same time, the ship ends up looking better in the long run. You get smoother parts, and overall, I think it's well worth doing. So I'm just going to go ahead and scratch those off a bit. They're not nearly as bad as what I've seen on some, like, plastic train sets. I had a couple of those as a kid, and those ones get pretty extreme with the plastic parts you have to punch out of the big cards and whatever. So that piece looks decent. Number 300 from Ocean's Edge. Now we've got the starboard side, the right side coming out here. Zeus is also one of the nicer looking ships in the game. You can see the lightning bolts both on the hull and on the sails. So it's a pretty cool looking ship overall. One of the cooler ships ever, really, in Pirates. Some people might say it's the coolest, but I'm not sure what my coolest ship would be. I think the Delusion comes close to taking the cake on that one, because Glow in the Dark, 10 Master. And Curse is even more, in my opinion, thematic for a 10 Master than Pirate. So there we've got a deck. Alright, so I gotta make sure I organize this. I'm gonna put Mast off to the side. I know I'm gonna be doing the decks first. You can look at this and see that I'm going to be attaching decks to a hull piece, and then from there, the other hull, and then the masts pretty much go in last. So I'm not going to worry about the masts for a little while. And then this one, the masts are easy. I'll probably say this later on too. The masts are easy with the Zeus because they're all three S's. All the cannons are the same ranks. So on other 10 masters, it gets confusing, and the card actually contradicts, you know, the actual masts. So it gets a little weird with some of the other 10 masters, so just beware of that. Alrighty, the Zeus is one of the more simple 10 masters. She only has a couple keywords. She's only got Junk and Horde, and Junk is just the ship type, so Horde is really the only ability. essentially, or the only extra one. So, and then Emperor Blackheart, of course, is a really great, powerful crew, but I already did a little mini review in the unboxing video, and I think I have all the pieces out, it looks like, hopefully. So I'm gonna put these masts over here. Got a lot of big masts there. Find that deck there. All right, so hopefully I'll do this right. I'm gonna wipe some of this debris off my little miniature ocean here. And hopefully I'll do this right. So I'm actually gonna look at the directions too, just to make sure I've got it and just to kind of show you my step-by-step process here. And yeah, like I said, it's been a while since I even built a 10 master. So hopefully I'll actually get it right. All right, so we've got, this is the main deck. And then I like to go, either side works to start. I think I usually like, I like to start with the starboard side. That's just what I'm used to. So 10 masters are tricky to build because you're building out three decks instead of one. Most ships just have one deck to attach a hull piece to. You can see here, there's like three pieces to attach right away, right from the start. To the hull piece, and then same to the other hull piece. So, and then of course, like with most junks, it requires some bending to fit. So I just start here, and then like with other ships, I just like to wiggle it in. And in this case, it's already going together well, so it's not too ridiculous. And 10 masters are weird too. I think I'm going to discover this soon. I'm trying to remember exactly how I've done it best in the past, but and some scratching may be a little bit normal, and it's okay to scratch off a little bit of paint on the, especially on the, you know, on the bottom sides. Like, I don't really care about the black parts, the undersides of the ship's parts. So some scratching of paint on those sides is quite all right. So, and yeah, I actually do feel kind of weirdly nervous in a way. So that's funny. So we've got the hull curvature there, or the deck curvature, I should say. And then where it gets weird, normally you would just go straight here with most ship types, but in this case we've got two other decks to fill out. So we've got this one here. So if you look at that one, that the smaller end, the narrower end, is supposed to be towards the stern, and then on top of that, just to make sure I have all the pieces set out, I've got this plate here where the slots look like they're aligned towards the stern. So I've got those two set up there. So now I've got to find spots for those. So hopefully I'm doing this right. This one goes here, this one goes in first. Biggest deck on the bottom, then you go up in size from there. So this one fits into the slot, that middle slot there. And then here, now we can curve the stern back. Most ships only have the curvature at the bow, but 10 masters are so large, they actually curve it at the stern instead. So I think I forgot to scratch off some of the pieces here. So I might just take it apart a tiny bit just to do that here. And then scratch off all the little tiny white parts. I really do think this makes the ship look better. It's a minor detail, but you know, when you've been collecting and building pirates for as long as I have, you notice pretty much all these little things over the years. So it'll make the ship look more beautiful and presentable at the end. It won't look like she's like hastily built with all the little white parts sticking out. And you wouldn't always be able to see that on a picture, of course, because it's a very fine detail. But anyway, all right. Oh yeah, so I just put that in the wrong slot. So that's how easy it is to mess it up. See, I put it in the top slot instead of the middle one, and then the back part doesn't curve around because then the part of the hull is in the way. So it's going together really easily right now. I haven't had to widen any slots or put any, you know, large amount of pressure on it. So I'm just going to try to get that flush against the deck. And then next you're supposed to get this little piece here. And then we put that into the top slot. This is tough because you don't really have any clearance below to get a finger underneath it. So you kind of have to, it's hard to get up close into the slot here. But what you can do, you can take this deck out. I might have to do that. You might have to take the middle deck out to get, you know, a better angle on this one. So let me just scratch this part off here, trying to remember that as I go along. And yeah, this is pretty much the opposite of my one master tutorial building video. Because that one was five total pieces. And then this one has, I have no idea, like 20 or something. So, all right, so this one might be the toughest part yet. And it's probably just gonna get tougher from here potentially. So I'm basically testing this out without the deck below to make sure it gets in. So I did get it in there because it was kind of tough without the deck below. Now that slot should be a little widened. So now it's kind of used to being in there. So I'm going to put this back in. And I guess I'll just do the stern part too. Make it somewhat flush there, or at least try to get it kind of flush. And now I hope that this goes in right away here. All right. Yeah, so that's going in there. And one good way to check whether you're getting things in well is if the slots kind of stick out a bit on the other side. If they're not sticking out much, it might look a little better, but it also means they're more loose and more likely to come apart easily. So I like to really kind of put some pressure on each side, not on the slot itself, but I kind of put it here, and you know, you don't want to crush anything, but you want to get the slots pretty well set in there. That's how I like to do it, at least. So just helps the ship's durability over time, then it won't, you know, less likely to fall apart during play. So if we look at the first step, that's almost it. There is this rudder part, so it looks like I'll have to go try that next. I think this is the mistake I made building 10 Masters in the past, is this rudder part at the stern is something no other ships really have a rudder. So we've got a stern part here, and it looks like, all right, so if we look at it here, we've got slots at the bottom, and then we can put the rudder part on after. So with slots at the bottom, and then of course the artwork sticking out. This is weird. I don't know if I've done it like this yet, but maybe that's why I've had to partially redo a 10 Master in the past. Now I think I'm just gonna do the rudder after the hull. I don't really wanna add that yet. So let me just make sure this hull piece has the little extra white parts scratched off. Looks pretty solid to me. And you can't always get them down to nothing. I'm not gonna like sand it or get an X-Acto knife or anything for that. So hopefully this will work on this hull piece. So we've got the starboard side in now. So if it was a shipwreck, you know, you could use it like that. But I'm certainly hoping this ship doesn't become a wreck anytime soon. So let me try to build it from here. So now all the slots should line up. It might just be tough, and I might have to disassemble some parts to get it in, but we're gonna see. So I'm just gonna, without doing too much pressure anywhere, I'm just gonna try to work in, I'm gonna go from the bottom once again and just work it in from the stern up with the bottom deck. But if everything lines up, it might also just kind of come together. We'll see. It looks like some of it is, but some of it's not. So we've got those two slots in there, at least partially. Let me see what I can do here. But it looks like it's too high on the other side. So let me just, and yeah, you can see all the white if you line it up properly here. So I might just try to do that. Let me see here. And it is tough to get close-ups on these tutorials because there's just so many moving parts, and you know, to build it right, it's good to have, one thing I like to say is it's good to have pressure points with your fingers. So it's good to have your fingers kind of surrounding the areas, especially where the slots go. You actually want to basically surround that with pressure, and that prevents like breaking. So like if I just try to punch this in from here rather than more like this, it's more likely to have a snap or have some kind of awkward getting together. And especially with the mast, if you try to put the mast in from the top, you know, they're going to be way more likely to break. So, all right, so that actually worked pretty well. We've got these four slots in here. So I'm just going to kind of gently go up towards the bow and then get the curvature of the hull piece going. I'm noticing, I don't know, your mileage may vary, but I'm noticing that this top part here with the hull curvature, or the deck curvature, I should say, is the hardest to get in. That was the case on the starboard side too. So this slot is a little tough. Yeah, so I just did a little extra pressure there with an index finger, and it's pretty much in. Then you can also look at the bottom of the ship to see what it's like. See, it's a little slanted out here because we don't have the rudder in yet. But it's going together pretty well so far. Hopefully I haven't made any mistakes. Boom. So you heard the snap there. That was the rudder. And now you can see, hopefully, right about there, you can see a little blue on the port side towards the back of the hull. So that's where I like to put pressure, not on the slot, but to either side. And then I just push it in. Oh, and then this part has to go in. Let me do that first. So I put the stern part in where the stern curves. And then going from bottom up, I'm just going to push that slot in, push that in a little bit more. And that one, So I am putting some pressure on the sides of the hull here. Not a ton, but you know, enough to get the slots sticking out a bit, make the ship pretty durable for the long run. Definitely not planning on deconstructing this anytime soon. So that looks good, and I think that's one of the harder parts, and it looks pretty good to me. I think I've done it right, so pretty happy with that so far. And then we can look at the instructions again. It's pretty simple. We've got one of the decks here, pretty much the top deck, it looks like. We can put the rudder in. Let me do that now that I've got both sides here. So the rudder has got a flat part that goes on the bottom. That's probably the easiest part of this ship, or one of the easiest, along with the flag. So we've got the rudder in. So now we've got the basic superstructure of the ship. Just got to put this deck on top. This deck actually holds 3 masts and the flag. This is an important part of the ship as well. So it's going to scratch off the little white pieces. And this is going to take less time than I thought too, which is neat. So that's good. So this one, similar to this deck, this middle deck here, it curves to the back. It curves inwards towards the stern. And then you can see the little flag slot there. So that makes it obvious that you should put that part towards the back of the ship, towards the stern. And this one is usually pretty easy. And yep, it's very easy. You barely have to curve this part of the hull at all, because there's not much curvature, so on the actual deck part. So you just curve it a tiny bit. That went in really easily. And this ship is kind of this is a nice build. This is easier than some of my other 10 masters. Can't remember which ones, but some of them went together kind of tough. So for an Ocean's Edge junk, this is actually going quite well and better than I could have expected. All right, so the next part is going to be the mast. So I've got those off to the right here. I haven't even used the Typhoon card yet, so that's nice. And I just popped the deck out because it's so fragile in there. So the masts, you might look for the other 10 masters, you might look front to back, but a lot of times it's misaligned. They kind of messed up some of the 10 masters, especially the Savage Shores one. I think the toughest, along with the Delusion. So with the masts, you'll get some weirdness with the mast. So for example, here we see this right mast has the mast showing. So obviously this other part with the stale should be pointing forward towards the bow. Then this other mast doesn't have it. It just has sails on both sides, which doesn't really make any sense. So that's probably not a misprint. It's probably the case with all Zeus's, but yeah, so anyway, so it just looks kind of silly, but whatever. And then, so you want to put the masts in order. So I know from experience, and you can kind of tell on the picture a little bit, but you basically want the curved masts at the bow. It's actually kind of easy to mess this part up. So these are the big 3. So I know these 3 go in the slot here. These are the kind of the main masts of the ship, even though they're kind of towards the front of the ship. Those are basically the main masts. She kind of has like 3 main masts instead of 1, for example, on like a 5-master. And then I know these 2 small ones that don't have any curvature, these 2 go at the very back. So I'm going to put those to the back there, to the right. I'm just going to go left to right. And then in this case, I see these 2. See how they're slanted? So if you put these against the ship, it'll look slanted. So those go at the curved part. These 2 go at the bow. So, and the smallest one goes in front. So it's going to look like that on the ship. So I'm going to put those there. And then these 3 go all together on that deck that I just put in. So these 3 go here. And you want the bigger ones in front and then the smaller one in the back. So they're going to look like that on the ship. So I'm going to put those there. And then in terms of which ones you put in for symmetrical mass, you can just do whatever one looks better in front or whatever you want to do with that. So I'm just going to go, I'm going to try my best to just go bow to stern. So just got that one in. One nice thing about 10 masters is the hull is so wide, the beam of the ship is pretty wide at the bottom. So you can actually get like a bunch of fingers underneath. So what I do with the mast, I like to have a finger, it might seem counterintuitive, I like to have a finger underneath the mast slot, not really pushing up, but just providing some support there, and I can start to feel the slot coming through. And then of course you have at least 2 fingers as close to the bottom of the mast, as close to the base as possible. And then I usually, sometimes I'll start it in an angle. If you don't do it in an angle and you just press right down, it can be a little weird. A lot of times you'll just have it snap into place, but I like to do a smooth wiggle rather than like a direct snap. Sounds like a football term. So I like to do a little wiggle. And then you can see the bottom, you might not be able to see it too well. Maybe with that, with the glare there, you can see that the slots are sticking down pretty far. So that's a good indication that they're all the way in. And then you can check on the ship as well to make sure that there's no part like sticking out. Like it would be a little weird there. And then it's kind of askew. It's kind of off. Or here, you know, it's not all the way down. And you can kind of tell by looking underneath. So you want to get it all the way down there and get a good firm mast placement. So here we've got these kind of this awkward mast. I think I might just put this one in front, because I don't really want it to look like that when you're looking from the back. So I think I'm just going to put this weird like double sailed mast in front actually. So like I was saying, sometimes there's slightly alternate artwork on the front and back of sails, so you can just kind of pick and choose. There can be a little bit of customization with masts in terms of where they go if they're, you know, equivalent placements. So the main masts are, you know, pretty much the biggest mast in the game, just about, I think the widest probably. So that one goes there. And then one thing with 10 masters that I don't like is that the masts are often either curved a little bit. I don't know if you can tell, this one's curved towards the stern in the middle, at least a tiny bit. Sometimes it's hard to notice. And then sometimes they're either too far back or too far forward. So I know it's kind of risky, but sometimes I kind of push them a little bit to try to make them look more like I want them to look. So once I get all three of the main masts in, I'm going to take a close look at it to see if there's any discrepancies and just see what it looks like. It's actually kind of hard to get the main mast of a 10-master to look completely perfect, because they're often like going forward or backwards a little bit. So, all right. So that one was a little tougher. I got it in. So yeah, see, they're kind of like, they kind of converge towards the top of the mast, so it's a little awkward. I might reverse this one right now, actually, just because that one doesn't have a mast showing. So I'm going to take this one out. So yeah, just wiggle. I was just wiggling the hull, and then I couldn't really get this finger all the way in there because there's a narrow space there. So you just have to be careful and just wiggle. So I'm really squeezing. Okay, another thing, yeah, so I'm squeezing the hull, but I'm squeezing where the slots are. So I've got the deck there for support, but if I held it here and squeezed just as hard, I would start snapping. I might snap both hull pieces at the same time if I was gripping it hard enough. So, all right, so just be careful there. And then here, once again, I'm going to have a finger underneath. So I'm just reversing this to try to make it look better. This is just really, like, minor aesthetic details. But, you know, it's a 10-master, so I want to do it right the first time. And I'm going to take some pictures of her, of the mighty Zeus, after I get this build done. All right, so that's way worse. So that actually made it worse, because now this mast is just crooked or weird. So sometimes you just have this happen. So I'm actually going to put it back. So that was an experiment to see if it would look better. It looks worse, so I'm blaming this weird mast. And maybe the other one is at fault a little bit too. But once again, like I said, it's weirdly difficult to get 10-master main masts, the big three masts, looking perfect. I don't know, they often have like a slant. It's kind of weird, but oh well. It probably has something to do with how I'm putting them in, but they should be pretty straight, so I don't know. All right, so now I've got this third one, because this one is shorter. You can tell this one is the shorter of the three, and this one goes on this deck here, but notice how my finger is blocked by the main deck, so I can't get something right under there, realistically, unless I took the other stuff out and put something under there, which I don't really think I need to do. This is where sometimes you kind of have to just accept a little bit of a bend in the deck. So this might go in a little tough the first time. And one thing I could have done that I don't think I really need to do is before I even built anything, pretty much, I could have widened that slot and even these other slots on these decks before I built the superstructure or like the main hull part of the ship. So, and yeah, there might be a little bit of a popping. That's not always a bad thing. And I'm really used to curving these decks a little bit. So that's not too bad. All right. Yeah, that looks all right. Now, I don't know if you'll be able to see it. Yeah, there's like a slight curvature in the middle of that deck there. You can kind of see it. So from putting the mast in, but that's almost inevitable, especially if you're going to play your ships like I do. I like to play a lot when possible. So when you take the mast out, put them back in, you're not going to take the ship apart every time. So anyway, sometimes you just have to compromise for time. So that's the first five. So we've got half the masts in. And then once again, just like that deck I just was putting masts into, this one's even higher up. So there's no way to get, you know, a finger or any kind of upward pressure from underneath. And just taking a quick peek at these masts, they look pretty much symmetrical on both sides. I don't really have a preference. Like if there was a lightning bolt on one of the masts, I would probably want that like facing out, for example. So these ones look the same. So I'm just gonna go left to right in this case. So this deck will also have some curvature. It's kind of tough. I think I'm gonna use the Typhoon card. Oh, I know what I'd do. Yeah, see, all right. So this is where sometimes it gets a little slow because I guess I'll try to show it real quick. You probably saw it. But when I'm trying to go in here, this is actually really curving that hull piece. So I don't wanna snap that or break it off at the tab. But this is nice because there's nothing really preventing you from just removing this deck manually. So I do that. This is how, yeah, I think this is how I've done most of the Ten Masters. Now that this is off, I can keep this straight with a finger underneath and then just do the mast from there and wiggle it in. And again, you could do this before you build anything or before you put this deck on for the first time. You could also keep this deck off while you're putting the first five masts in because there's nothing, you don't have to keep it in there to put the other masts in. So that mast is going to go on the port side, and then this one's going to go on the starboard side. I like this because now I can keep the deck nice and straight. So I'm basically just putting these masts in and testing them. I could use another piece as well, but I want to use the actual mast as well. Or I want to use the actual mast because then I can kind of narrow the base of the mast at the same time that I'm widening the slots on the deck part. So this one is tough, actually. So I'm really glad I'm doing it this way because you wouldn't want to force this and then break this top deck. Or even if you didn't break it, you could make it curve like a lot, which would be kind of noticeable when you're playing or when you take close-up pictures, stuff like that. So I'm just going to wiggle all three in. What I've done in the past, I don't know if I'm going to do it now. I might have to. I think in the past, I've put all three of these masts in and then put the deck on after. So you could do that. You could have like a whole separate deck all constructed and then put it back on. But I might do that. I don't know how this is going to go. I'm just going to try to... I think I'm just going to try to build it like I wanted to. Put the deck on first. Make sure that's pretty much flush against the slots there, sticking up. Now I'm going to try this again, because now it's going to go in a lot easier. See how much easier that was? The deck still bends a little bit, but it's not as much of a permanent bend. So there's not like a big curvature going downward in the deck there. All right, so this is where it gets tricky, to be honest, because now I have almost no wiggle room, literally, on either side. And I've got to put that one in the back there, the other one, I should say. So what I'm going to do is just try to get it in there. I don't know if this is going to work the first time or not. Just gonna go from this side here. Just gonna try to wiggle it without too much pressure. Yep, so since I already loosened it, it is gonna go in. I'm not holding the mast at a very optimal position, but since I already loosened up that slot, it goes in pretty well. So then I can look at the top to make sure it looks pretty much symmetrical. And then I can work on this third one, which is gonna be a similar positioning. I can't hold the mast as far towards the base as I'd like to. I'm just gonna be careful, go slow. And then I'm gonna try to wiggle it in. Again, there's other ways you can do this, but this is how I like to do it. And I'm not really, I don't know, I'm not as afraid of breaking stuff as other people. Partly because, you know, I've already broken enough ships, so it's like, whatever. And because I've been doing this for a long time, I've probably built not too far off from 1,000 ships now. I've got over 800 punched, I figure, by now. So, I think I built almost all of those, so, you know, I've done this before, to say the least. So, now I've got the last two masts here, so I got those three in. They look pretty good to me. So I've got the last two, which are really easy. These just go on the final deck here. So I'm just gonna plop these in. So that goes there. And then this one. The second one is a little tougher because sometimes you have to kind of hold it towards the top a little bit, but usually they go in easily and they're tiny, so that's nice. And then we've got the stern flag, and then that's gonna be it. So there's that. And the Zeus is complete. So thanks for watching. Let me know any comments about this video. Question of the day is, have you built a Ten Master before? So feel free to answer that in the comments. And the mighty Zeus is now ready to set sail. So this was the Ten Master building video, and I've successfully built the Zeus. Thanks for watching.